Hello everyone, welcome back to the course. So far we have identified actors in our complex problem and designed their individual problem statements. Remember the case in the video on problem statements about gas drilling in the Netherlands, which caused small earthquakes to occur. For the ministry, we designed the following problem statement. How to provide the Dutch citizens with energy and heating without compromising the safety of the citizens. It is clear what the problem is, as the objective of the ministry is very clear: provision of energy, but in a safe way. As you can imagine, a lot of people, different actors as we would call them, have their ideas on what to do, so the Dutch citizens are provided with energy in a safe way. If you want to choose one of all the different alternatives, you would like to compare them. And for comparing, we need a set of clear criteria. What we need to have is a set of criteria that represents the problem as stated in the problem statement. So we need criteria that represent the provision of energy and the safety issue at the same time. How do we do that? Well, let's take a look at this animated example. This is the Minister of Economic Affairs. Today, we are going to ask him some concrete questions so we can design criteria for the problem the ministry faces. Here I start. Hello there, Minister. What is it that you want to achieve during your period as Minister of Economic Affairs?
That's a good question. I think it is important to reduce the CO2 emissions caused by generating electricity.
So, here it is. In the right down corner, low CO2 emissions. We include the unit already, so this goal is measurable. Now the next step. The most important question you can ask as an analyst, consultant or manager is why. Let's try. Dear Minister, why do you want to reduce CO2 emissions when generating electricity?
Well, in this way, the Dutch state contributes to creating environmental friendly energy.
By asking why, you identify goals on a higher level. In this case, reducing CO2 emissions is not a goal in itself. The minister wants to reduce these emissions to supply the Dutch citizens with environmental friendly electricity. You can keep on asking why, until the questions or answers become very obvious. Here we go. But Minister, why is creating environmental friendly energy so important?
Well, in that way, the Dutch citizens can make use of a sustainable energy supply.
We have constructed a hierarchy of goals now. However, do we already have a good set of criteria? Not really. This hierarchy is represented by only one criterion, low CO2 emission, in the right down corner. For sure, sustainable energy supply means much more than only low CO2 emissions. You find these criteria by asking, what is this, for every goal in this tree. For example, we ask, what is sustainable energy supply? A possible answer could be widely available and cheap energy. These subgoals are added to the tree, and by asking, what is this again, also these subgoals can be further specified. All goals in the bottom layer of the goal tree can be used in a later stadium as criteria to measure the effects of each alternative we want to consider. To be able to really measure, you add units to all goals in the lowest layer of the goal tree. This is sometimes hard. If it is difficult to find units, please try to formulate the goals even sharper until you are capable of identifying a clear unit for each. Goals that you can quantify, that is, measure in numbers, usually get more attention in decision making than goals that can only be measured qualitatively. The goal tree in this example is for the Minister of Economic Affairs. Making goal trees for all actors in your complex situation shows what criteria all actors will use for their decision making. You as analyst or consultant want to create the overview. Out of all these goal trees, you identify a set of criteria that you will use in the further analysis of your complex situation.
Hello, my name is Will Thyssen. I'm a professor of policy analysis at the Faculty of Technology, Policy and Management at Delft University of Technology. My background is in systems and control engineering, and I had a strong interest from the beginning in applying systems thinking to public decisions. After my PhD, I practiced for 5 years as a policy analyst within the Dutch government, and then returned back to university, where I'm now involved in leading research in the fields of energy and water management in particular. As an educated systems engineer, my impression was that decision making is about finding the best solution to control a system. But in practice, if we look at public decision making, it's also a process of and between actors, between stakeholders. And that perspective is crucial. A lot of questions come up. Who are the key players, the key stakeholders? How do they look at the situation? What are their objectives and criteria? In my experience, looking from this actor perspectives into the different objectives and criteria is a good first stepping stone towards a successful problem analysis.
Let's give you another example. A high school student just finished high school. For some of you, that may be a situation of a long time ago, but for others, it might just have happened a few years ago. Finally, graduation. But what to do now? There are so many possibilities. So let's help this graduate in his decision making. How? Well, by identifying criteria with a goal tree that will help him to decide on his next step after high school. The first question is, hey, high school graduate, what do you want? The first thing that pops into the mind of the student is good courses. Apparently, he wants to go to college. The next question is, why does the student want that? The answer could be for the purpose of high quality education. Again, this goal tree is not finished. To complete it, the next question is, what is this exactly, high quality education? The student answered that this is about a well-spread study effort. Repeating the what is this question results in the lowest layer of the goal tree with criteria that can be used to score different alternatives.
Hi everyone, it's time for action again. As a first step, please study section 2.3 of the book. After that, create goal trees for as many actors as are involved. Make sure all the lowest level goals are operational. Each of them must be measurable. Also, each lower level goal should have a unit. Make sure that all the operational goals can easily be transformed into criteria. Simply removing words like lower or less should do the trick. When you have designed all these goal trees, identify a set of criteria for the rest of your analysis. You do this by taking all the lower level goals from all your goal trees. Remove the overlap, as there will be many goals that are very comparable. Of the remaining goals, remove words like higher, lower, and faster, so you really turn these goals into independent criteria. The amount of criteria can differ a lot. Sometimes you only have 4, while in other cases you can get as much as 200. The most important thing is the following. Does this set of criteria represent your problem well? If people could only have information about these criteria and about nothing else, would they be able to make a decision? If that is the case, you have a good set of criteria. Let's discuss some very common mistakes when constructing goal trees and making criteria. Many goals often become too broad. That is the case if the goal is always true, that is, always, even when there is no problem. Such always true goals are what the actor is striving for in every situation. The opposite problem is when main goals are too specific. In that case, you have focused so much in a certain direction of the problem that there is hardly any solution space left. Then you only have a very limited set of alternatives instead of a huge variety. Chances are that you get stuck. Chances are also that you stay in the same situation as before the analysis, when you were focusing on only one solution. You had huge discussions with other actors and were unable to reach a decision. When constructing a goal tree from more abstract goals to more specific ones, the question to answer is, what is this? Many people, however, do not ask this question, but ask, how can this be reached? Or simply, how? In doing this, the answer will give a causal relation between the upper abstract goals and the lower subgoals. The idea is that a goal tree defines upper abstract goals in concrete lower subgoals. It is not the idea that a goal tree tells how these goals can be reached. In that case, you would introduce alternatives in your goal tree. This is very dangerous, as the goal tree is constructed to get criteria. The criteria you identify are used in your analysis to compare alternatives. So, what happens if you would include an alternative in your goal tree? you would have a very specific criterion on your set that only relates to one alternative. This creates a bias in your analysis, as this alternative will always score on its own criterion. As soon as actors sense bias in an analysis towards a criterion or alternative, they might take your work less serious. Please show us what you can come up with. In the webinar of this week, we will give you some reactions and feedback on the work of some of you. And, of course, react on the most common questions raised in the discussion forum. Good luck and see you next time!